So let's go ahead and get started. In today's lecture, we're gonna talk about the application of the theodolite. But before we start, what is the theodolite? The theodolite is an instrument used commonly by builders and engineers to measure precise angles, which is necessary for large-scale construction projects. So we use the theodolite in order to measure the angles precisely. And the theodolite look like that here. A basic modern optical theodolite typically consists of a small telescope. So here we are going to have a small telescope, which is connected to two angle measuring mechanism. This one is connected to two angle mechanism. So through this telescope, we will be able to measure the vertical angles and the horizontal angles. We have one to measure the, yes?
My switch here.
Okay, sorry. Thank you for letting me know that. كده واضح دحين؟ شير واضح؟
نعم.
Okay. So let's go ahead and get started. In today's lecture, we are going to talk about the application of the theodolite. But before we talk about the theodolite, we need to understand the device itself. The theodolite is an instrument used commonly by builders and engineers to measure precise angles. And the precise angle is necessary for large-scale construction projects. The device look like that. And this device consists of a small telescope. Here we have a small telescope. And this small telescope is connected to two angle measuring mechanisms. We have two mechanisms. The first one for horizontal angles, and the second one for measuring the vertical angles. So this telescope is connected to two angle measuring mechanisms, one for the horizontal angles and the other one for vertical angles. And it sits atop a rotated base with a leveling mechanism on tripod. So this telescope is connected to a rotatable base. So this base can be rotated. And sits atop a tripod. We need a tripod so that we can fix the theodolite on it. Once the theodolite is set up, the telescope is turned to a spot, the desired point. And then the angle from the point that the theodolite is placed to the point spotted in its telescope can be read through the eyepiece of the telescope. Then first we need to determine the starting point, and we are going to make the angle zero in case that I need to determine the horizontal angle. And then we are going to move the device into the ending point and then get the measured. Similarly, regarding the vertical, I'm going to spot the desired point and measure the angle, because in the vertical angle we have the reference is already has been set. The device is look like that. Here we have the eyepiece, the eyepiece from here, this one. And here we have the side axis, and here we have the object. You can see the object through this object, okay? And we have vertical axis here, and we have horizontal axis. So here we have vertical axis, and also we have horizontal axis. Regarding the vertical axis, this one is going to be the reference for the vertical point. So the zero for the vertical point is here. Okay, assume your object is here. Then the vertical angle is going to be measured from the vertical axis to the desired point or the desired object, like that. Regarding the vertical angle, here also we have this rotating base, and we need to determine the reference. You are going to set the reference for you by press on the set here. Then, for example, this place is going to be your reference. The angle here is going to be zero. Then you are going to turn the device until you get the next point. So this one, this angle here represent the angle between this line and that line. So regarding the application of the theodolite, we know that we can determine the angles, whether it's vertical or horizontal, through the theodolite. But we have another applications regarding the theodolite. We can use the theodolite in order to measure an elevation of a point. So if this point, for example, we need to know the elevation of that point, we can use the theodolite in order to know the elevation of that point. And also we'll be able to measure an object height. If you have a mountain or a tower, also through the theodolite, we'll be able to determine that height. And also we could measure the length or the width of obstructed building. If you have this length like that and you are not able to determine that length using the traditional method, maybe you have some obstacle here, so you can use the theodolite to determine this width. Okay, so we have three main applications for the theodolite. First, we are going to walk you through the first one, which is measuring an elevation of a point. So assume that you need to determine the elevation of the point B, and you don't have a level and a road to do that, and you need to determine that using the theodolite. So in this case, the theodolite is going to be set up under a known point. So this is going to be a benchmark or a point with known elevation. The first condition, the theodolite should be set up on a known point. If this one is a known point, it means that the height of the point A is known. Then we are going to measure the height of the instrument. It's going to be referred by the letter L. So the letter L represents the height of instrument. HA represents the height of the point A. Then this line, this green line, represents the reference for the vertical angles. And here we have the point that we need to determine its elevation. Then we need to cite that point, and then we are going to measure this angle here from the device. And then we'll be able to determine the value of alpha. The value of alpha is going to be 90 minus the angle from the device, which is this one. Now we will be able to determine the value of alpha. And we know that tan of alpha is going to be the opposite over adjacent. The opposite represents the distance from here to here. The adjacent is the value of D. Also, we need to measure the distance from the device to the building. So we need to know this distance here. And in order to determine the distance from here to here, we know that tan alpha is going to be this value over D, which means that the distance from here to here is going to be the distance D times tan alpha. Now the elevation of the point A is going to be the elevation of the point, the elevation of the point B is going to be the elevation of the point A, which is here, plus the value, the height of the instrument, which is referred to by the letter L, then plus this distance from here to here is going to be D times tan alpha. So the height of the point B is going to be the height of the point A plus the height of an instrument Li plus D time alpha, the distance from here to here. Now I'm going to show you a small example regarding this application. Here we have the MSL, the mean sea level, and here we have a tower, and we need to determine the value of the highest point on the tower, the value, the elevation of the point B. So in order to do that, I need to set up my device on a known point, on a benchmark. For example, so this point here, the height of this point should be known. So now the device has been set up on a known point, and the point came out to be 35 meters. So distance from here to here is 35 meters. And also I need to measure the height of the instrument. The height of an instrument came out to be 1.51 meter. And also I need to determine the distance from the device to the tower. And the distance came out to be 45 meters. Now, what should I do? I know this one represents the reference. I'm going to spot these points through the device, and then I'm going to write this angle from the device. Okay, because the device cannot directly measure this angle for me. And I'm going to call this alpha 2. Alpha 2 came out to be 50 degrees 8 minutes, 48 seconds. Now, I got all the data from the field. Now I'm going to make my calculation. So in the calculations, we know that the height of the point B equals the height of the point A plus I plus D tan alpha. The value of HA is given. The value of I, it's also given. The value of D is given, but we don't know the value of alpha. But easily we can determine the value of alpha, this one. The value of alpha is going to be 90 minus alpha 2. 90 minus alpha 2 is going to give me the value of alpha. The value of alpha came out to be 39 degree 51 minutes 12 seconds. So now I know the value of alpha. I'm going to substitute all of these numbers into this formula. Okay, I know the value of HA, the value of I, the value of D, and the value of alpha. And the height of point A came out to be 47.073 meters. And this one represents the distance from here to here, because this one is elevation of a point. Okay. Also, we can determine the object, measuring the height of an object. It could be a tower or a building. I will be able to determine the height from here to here. So in order to do that, I need to know the value of alpha and the value of beta. Okay, and also I need to know the distance from here to here. In this application, I don't need the height of the instrument, and also I don't need a value of the benchmark. The device, it can be set up on any point. As long as this point is convenient for me, I can see the highest point and the lowest point. And if I know the value of alpha and the value of beta, then this distance is going to be D times tan alpha. And this distance here is going to be D times tan beta. And the final height is going to be D times tan alpha plus D times tan beta. Okay, so the height of the tower is going to be D times alpha plus D times beta. I can take D as a common factor. So the height of the tower is going to be D times tan alpha plus tan beta. So let's see an example regarding the height of an object. Here we have this tower, and we need to determine the height of that tower, which means the distance from here to here. The first step, we are going to set up the device on any random point. The only condition that this point is going to be convenient for me, I can see the highest point and the lowest point. As long as in this position, I will be able to see the highest point and the lowest point, the location is going to be convenient. We know this one is the reference angle. Here we have the zero angle. And then I'm going to cite the highest point, and I'm going to record alpha 2, this angle here. And also I'm going to cite the lowest point, and also I'm going to record the angle here. We're going to call this alpha 2 and this one alpha 3. Also, I need to measure the distance from the device to the building, this one here. The value came out to be 35 meters. So now I have all the data required to determine the height of that tower. So I know alpha 2, alpha 3, and I know the distance. I have all the parameters, okay? And the height of the tower is going to be D times alpha plus D times tan beta, okay? So the value of D is given. The value of alpha, it's not given directly, and the value of beta also is not given directly, but I can determine them. And the distance here is given, of course. I need to, this angle here represent alpha. Okay, and this one here represent beta. So the value of alpha is going to be 90, this angle, minus alpha 2, this one. Okay, so 90 minus this angle here is going to give me the value of alpha. Similarly, the value of beta is going to be alpha 3, minus 90. So regarding the beta is going to be alpha 3, this one, minus 90. So by this, I'm going to be able to determine alpha and beta. Now I've got everything required for the formula. So the height of the tower, I know the value of D, I know the value of alpha, I know the value of beta. I'm going just to plug in the numbers and get the value of the height of the tower. And the height of the tower came out to be 35.705 meters. So now we determine the value of the height of the building. Now let's talk about the last applications. The last applications, we need to measure the length or the width of an obstructed building. So let's say we are not be able to determine this width, width using the tape. So we can do that using the theodolite. First, I need to select a baseline AB. We're gonna assume that the width is starting point is C and the ending point is D. I'm going to set up a baseline. I'm gonna call it AB. And I need to measure the distance between the two lines. Then I'm going to set up the theodolite at the point A. Then I'm going to side the point D, okay, and make the angle zero, the vertical angle zero. Then I'm going to side the point C. Then I'm going to record the horizontal distance. I'm going to call this alpha one. Then I'm going to set the device or the angle to be zero. Then I'm going to side the point B. And I'm going to record this angle as alpha 2. Then I'm going to move the device to the point A. I'm going to side the point C and make the angle 0. Then I'm going to side the point D and get the reading here. I'm going to call this alpha 3. Then I'm going to set the device here to 0. And then I'm going to turn it to the point A and measure the alpha 4. So now I know alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 4. And the distance between A and B. This is all I got, or this is all I want from the field. Alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 4, and the distance between the point A and the point B. Now, I'm going to go to the office and determine the calculation. So, first I need to determine alpha 5. So this one represents alpha 5. We know that the summation of the angles of internal triangle the summation is 180, and then the value of alpha 5 is going to be 180 minus alpha 1 plus alpha 2 plus alpha 4. Similarly, I can determine the alpha 6. Again, I'm going to use this triangle. The summation of the internal angles is 180, and then the value of alpha is going to be 180 minus alpha 2 minus alpha 3 and minus alpha 4. So now I determine the value of alpha 5 and alpha 6. Now I'm going to use the sine law to determine the value of AC and also the value of AD. Regarding the value of AC, I'm going to use this triangle here. The value of AC over the sine of alpha 3 plus alpha 4 equals the value of AB, which I know, over the sine alpha 6. This one, because this angle is opposite to that line. Okay, that is why we say that AB over sine alpha 6. Also, I can determine the value of AD, this one, but I'm going to use this triangle. Okay, so in order to determine AD, the length of AD over the sine alpha 4, because this angle is opposite to that length, is going to equal the value of AB, this one, over the opposite angle, which is sine alpha 5. So I can determine the value of AC, and also I can determine the value of AD. Finally, if I know the value of AC and the value of AD, I'm going to use this triangle here to determine the value of CD. I'm going to use the cosine law. So if I'm going to use a cosine law, the value of CD is going to be the square root of the length, square root of the length AD, AC squared, plus the length AD squared, minus 2 times the length AC, times the length AD cosine alpha 1. Okay, cosine alpha 1, because the length CD is opposite to this angle, which is alpha 1. Okay, so this is how we determine the value of CD. Here we have example regarding determining the distance CD. Here we set up the line AB and we record the distance, and we set the device on the point D and make it zero, and then side the point C, we measure the angle alpha 1 like we explained, and this is the value of alpha 1, this is the value of alpha 2, this one the value of alpha 3, and this one is the value of alpha 4. So now I got everything from the field. I'm going to get to the office to determine the value of CD. So I have all of the parameters, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 4, and the distance AB here. And I'm going to determine alpha 5. Alpha 5 is going to be 180 minus alpha 1 plus alpha 2 plus alpha 4, come out to be 13 degrees 35 minutes. Similarly, I can determine the value of alpha 6. Again, the value of alpha 6, this one, is going to be 180 minus alpha 3 plus alpha 4 plus alpha 2. The value came out to be 8 degree 39 minutes 40 seconds. Now, using the sine law and using the triangle ABC, I'm going to determine the value of AC. The value of AC is going to be the value of AB times sine alpha 3 plus alpha 4 over sine alpha 6. The value came, the value of AC came out to be 62.421 meters. Also, I can determine in the same manner using this triangle ACD. I can determine the value of AD using the sine law. The value of AD came out to be 37.109 meters. And finally, I'm going to use the cosine law to determine the value of CD using this formula. Okay, I have the value of AC, it's given here. The value of AD, it's also given. We know the value of AC, the value of AD, and the value of alpha 1 is here. So I've got everything I need. I'm going to plug in the numbers, and the value of CD came out to be 44.304 meters. So I measured the value of CD, the width of this building, without using any tape. I just used the Theodo light. Okay, I'm going to stop here. If you have any questions, please ask me.